Hello, my name is Colin McGraw from Pentagon Solutions. In this short video, we'll be looking at the artifact viewer in RedEye. So, this is the artifact viewer in RedEye. We'll start with the left-hand side. Up the top here, you should just get your generic details about what artifact you're looking at, the artifact number, artifact name, what workflow it's in, the artifact type, file type. Then you also get another sort of view of what stage of the workflow it's at. So as you can see, I submit a red pen submission and I've checked it out for Brafton. And you can see this kind of next couple of steps that still have to come. You can see basically you get a view of the artifact as well. You can see, oh, I've submitted that red line. You can print that red line. You can download the version status of the file. And you can also report it. So if you think, oh, that artifact name is wrong or it's in the wrong workflow, you can report that to your bucket administrator and they'll be able to fix it. On the right hand side, you have metadata. So metadata is important, obviously, in RedEye because of the searching. So if you're missing metadata fields, this artifact then isn't easily a search for and therefore loses a bit of efficiency when you're talking about RedEye. So you should make sure all metadata fields that are necessary are added on and filled out. You can add new ones or you can remove them. So, you know, if I wanted to delete the longitude or latitude, I could. Then the next thing is history. So basically you have a list of the different changes and who's done them, who's performed them, the timestamp. So I've checked, I've made a red pen markup, but I've also reviewed a draft before. So if I was to compare those, you would kind of just say, oh, really the only thing that's changed is the red line. But if this was an actual drawn, maybe you'd see the change of the red line implemented, or you could go back to previous versions of the artifact and find what it started out as and how it's changed over time. You can overlay that, or you can have it as an overlay or have it as a split, depending on how you like to view it. And you can, you know, change the fade if you only want the sort of newer changes to be slightly visible, or you want them to be the most prominent. You can mess with the fade. The other thing you can do is link artifacts together from here. So I have a different artifact. If I wanted to unlink it, I could click link artifacts and then just tick one and select link, and then it will come up there and you click into it, or I could upload a new one and link it automatically. Then it just comes up here and you're able to click into it and it takes you to that view. Tools, basically you have kind of your cleanup. So maybe there's duplicates in your buckets, or metadata is empty. Cleanup tools kind of points those out, those artifacts out. You can delete the artifact from here. You can see anybody who's accessed it. OCR extract is more for documents with content in them, like words. And then when you perform the search, if you enable OCR extract on that artifact, you'll be able to search through that artifact in RedEye. There's also fixed artifact PDFs, fresh preview. So if you've maybe made a change and it's not shown, you can refresh it there. There's different ones for CAD, like refresh the drawing lead, or search for CAD metadata, CAD for artifact number. You can upload and download the current revision or latest revision, and you see just have all the tunes in there. And then any child artifacts will come up here in related, or any parent artifacts will come up here in related as well. One other thing I wanted to show is just the sort of 3D viewer. So you have quite a few options in here, whether it be like your different measurement tunes. You can measure distance and stuff, or you can measure angles and calibrate, and you know, change the sort of settings you want to use. You can go into first person. You can you can explode the model. So I wanted to look at a specific part of the model, I could do that. You can also view artifact properties, or the model properties from in here, whether it be a specific item that you click on. There's also settings based on the navigation, how you want that to run, the environment, the lighting, and there's quite a few options in there. You can full screen it, which obviously, depending on the size of your model, is what you want to do. You can change how you sort of move about, whether that be orbit or pan, or you can zoom in. You can sort of change the way the camera interacts as well. And then, as you can see, it's still based on, you know, metadata filled out. You search for it, this is what comes up. You can see the stage of workflow it's in. You can see all the history. It's been through a couple. That's all for the artefact here on RedEye. Thank you for listening.